Hey guys, this is Jonathan from Fitness for Freedom. Today we are going to go through how to do the bear squat properly and all the progressions that you could do to make it harder or easier depending on whatever your level is. Now, what I like about the bear squat is that it's a really dynamic exercise. There are lots of variations to do, and it will really target your chest, your shoulders, your arms, your quads, and your glutes. So it really is a full body exercise. And depending on what level you're at, you should always make it, or you could always make it, part of your warm up at the very least, okay? Now, to set up properly, or to do the most basic version of the bear squat, you're going to set up in a quadruped position, okay? With your hands directly beneath your shoulders, your knees in line with your hips, okay? You're going to pop your knees up off the floor and you're just going to hold it, okay? And as you're holding this position, I want you to push through your shoulder blades, or sorry, push through your armpits here, excuse me, so that you're really using your shoulder stabilization muscles, okay? And you're going to stay right in this position and just hold it, okay? But once you can hold that position for a minute, which many people will probably be able to do when they're first starting out, then you're ready for something that's a little bit more challenging, okay? Now, the next version up is the bear squat where we're going to move, okay? So your feet will be a little bit further apart for this one. Your shoulders are going to be over your hands. You're going to be in a basically a hand plank position, maybe with your shoulders a bit further forward than they normally would be, okay? You're going to drive your bum back, okay, towards your heels. So a lot of people have a tendency to get their bum way up high in the air, but I want you to keep your bum down low towards your heels, and you're going to drive your shoulders forward over your hands. You're going to shift back and forth like this, okay? And by doing this, what that does is you still get a very similar load on your chest, arms, and shoulders, but you're going to get your quads a lot more involved, okay? So your body's going to feel, your whole body's going to be a little bit more active through the whole motion, okay? So once you can do about 15 of those in a row, and maybe you're ready for the next variation up. The next variation up is, I call it a fire hydrant bear squat, okay? So you're gonna be in this position here, with your shoulders over your hands, and you're just going to kick your leg up like this and then bring it back down. Only about an inch, still pushing through your shoulders, okay? So that your shoulder blades aren't collapsing towards each other and without twisting your hips or turning. So I don't wanna see any of this business while you're lifting up, okay? So just out to the side, just a couple inches, and then lower it back down, okay? Now, once you can do, again, 12 or 15 repetitions of that, let's move up to the next one, okay? So same exact position, except instead of going out to the side, you're going to kick your leg, okay, straight back just like this, staying as flat as you can the whole time, okay? So leg straight back, and then in. And what you're going to do, or what you're going to notice, is that that really loads up your quad muscle, okay, a lot more. So those are sort of the basic progressions of the bear squat. Now, maybe you work out with a partner, or you would like your workout to be a little bit more interesting, and that's where the bear crawl can come in. So the bear crawl is the exact same setup of an exercise, except we're going to move as we do it. So it might look something like this. We're going to set up in the position here with our shoulders over our hands, okay? Feet relatively close together, and what you're going to do is take a step forward, keeping everything as flat as you can. You should technically be able to do this with a ball on your back, okay? And that way you know you're not twisting or turning and you're staying as flat as possible. Now, if you're with a partner and you have a little bit of open space, what I might recommend doing is setting up a little race, okay? So where you're trying to get from one end to the other, except you're not trying to do it as fast as you possibly can, you're trying to do it as slow as you possibly can. And by doing a bear crawl as slow as you can, what that's going to do is it's really going to test your mental toughness in terms of how long you can push yourself to hold it, and it gives you someone to sort of compete against, which might make it a little bit more fun or a little bit more interesting than a regular workout could be. So that's the bear squat. I hope you found this video helpful, useful, or entertaining. If you did enjoy it, please subscribe to our channel or like our page, because we deliver content just like it every week. Take care, and we'll talk to you next time.